actually one of the biggest pressure that has come on Pakistan today is because of the proceedings of the FATF, I guess. And FATF has created so much of a pressure on them that probably no other action could have been. If you could collect the information, correct information, sustainable information, quotable information which can be put up in the international forums and platforms effectively, that is how Pakistan, everybody knows that Pakistan is supporting terrorism, Pakistan is financing terrorism, but the point is that in these forums, it is the evidence that. And only you people can this thing. Firstly, you have got the access to this, and secondly, you understand how an information is converted into evidence. And if there is an evidence, how can it be made something that can withstand scrutiny? So you can all contribute in a small way. Probably it can be converted by the NIA. NIA is, you know, I call them for the meeting when we are talking about the whatever the evidence available. Not that we are targeting any particular country, but the facts are facts. So if you get to know the real facts, it is our duty to put it to the and they are put at the right places in the right forum and in an effective way. And I do think that, well, we should continue our efforts. So depend on the facts, preserve the facts, put them into the format, don't destroy them, put them into the fact, they may be usable, nationally and internationally. Even if we have got to say that when Pakistan is sponsoring terrorism, where is evidence? Don't destroy the evidence, you have got plenty of. Similarly, in case you have to do the perception management, and you say that when the Pakistanis are doing about that, you have so many Pakistani people who are arrested. There is no harm in giving their identities, giving their plans, giving their this thing to the media. Let the world know about it. Just keeping them into the straitjacket of this thing does only benefits Pakistan.